Hey y'all, I'm back to show y'all a really cute wig, okay? So if you're interested in how I styled this cute Goldilocks wig, stay tuned. So I'm taking it out the box. I wanted to show you ladies how pretty the curl was. The construction, two combs on the side, one in the back, and a band. And of course it comes with this faux lace. I freaking hate it, the faux scalp. So I had to perform open lace surgery on this wig and remove this unneeded, unwanted extra piece of cloth they call a fake scalp, okay? So that's what you see me doing. And even though I haven't really sped up to the highest speed that I could, I actually took my time, and it took me probably about 10 minutes to remove it. So I decided to do a really low right side part. When I took this holy wig out of the box, I got a real 80s type of feel with this wig. So I kind of wanted to do cute, 80s side part, kind of with all a whole bunch of hair in your face, looking real cute and mysterious and whatnot. So I decided to do that. So, and I've been obsessed with swirlies lately. So I've been doing really cute little swirlies with my baby hair. That takes a little time, but once you style it, hurry up and freeze it into place with the blow dryer and it should stay and be fine, okay? So I am doing the same thing on both sides. I'm going in and I'm styling my baby hair, and y'all, styling this lace front on this wig was just like butter, okay? It was so easy, so flawless. I didn't have to pluck or do anything, any manipulation to this lace front. It was absolutely easy to go in, style the baby hair how I want it, and envision it to look. And I definitely achieved that with no time, okay? So yeah, that's what you see me doing. I am styling the baby hair on the lower right side of the wig. And I decided to do a little bit of light sideburn action on each side, because I do intend on gluing the wig, the whole lace front down, okay, when I apply the wig, okay? That's pretty much, what I'm doing, and I'm definitely going to freeze this side in place. And now I take my Fit Me in a color 330, and I apply it to all of the gaps in between the baby hairs, the parts, and everywhere that the lace is shown on the lace front, okay? So that's what you see me doing. I don't really have a pattern in particular. I just make sure it's covered, it's brown, and it looks good, okay? That's what I do. So I just, apply it. Oh, I also apply it at the top just in case I'm bending my head down and somebody see the top of my head and, I didn't want it to look white and pasty, because I don't know why, but they get the faux material right, the color right for that material, but they don't seem to apply that same color to the lace. So, yeah, voila, it's done. Now, I decided to go in with my L'Oreal Root Touch-Up spray and lightly spray this wig in different places along the ends of the hair, in front of the hair, because the color just seemed really, really turned up to me, y'all. Like, when I took this pretty wig out the box, I was like, oh my god, like, this gold is really turned up, y'all. So, I took my L'Oreal Touch-Up in a color dark brown, and I'm just lightly spritzing it throughout the hair. And I actually like that it toned down the goldness of the hair, so I am pleased. And voila, the finished product all installed, and she is cute, y'all. Okay, she was giving me real Mariah Carey in her heyday when she first came out with that beautiful flowing curly locks hair, you dig? Okay, that's what she's giving.
Hey, JuiceDrops, JuicyNashae here, and I'm back to show you lovely ladies a beautiful wig. what's the name of this cute wig right here? Her name is Cheyenne, and she is made by Outre Perfect Hairline. Now, if my voice sounds a little weird, unfortunately, I am under the weather. So my pronunciation of certain words might be a little off, but please bear with me, okay? So, she's made by Perfect Hairline, but I'm not gonna go into the details. I will add them right here. Okay, let me show you ladies a quick close-up. I did glue her on both sides, which is kind of rare when I wear my hair like this, but because this wig is so big head friendly, I definitely was able to glue her down on both sides. So I'm gonna show you ladies, this is the right side without losing my earring on camera. So this is how I did it on the right side. I decided to go with the right side part, a curved part. And I kind of just, you know, wanted to do some, you know, like a 1980s kind of like side part style, you know, just, you know, cause it's cute, you know, it's cute. And it's giving me real cute. So I did a little swirly right here. It's kind of lazy, but I kind of like that. It kind of gives it a little bit of natural flavor, you know, all right? So going on to this side, I just kind of, you know, did some baby hair going along my forehead, and I have some sideburn action on this side as well. Okay, so now that I showed you ladies the close-up, I'm gonna show you ladies the 360. Okay, pro number one for Miss Cheyenne would definitely have to be that she is big head friendly, y'all, okay? She's big head friendly. I was able to glue her down on both sides, which is kind of rare when you're being advertised a 13x6 wig. Not every 13x6 wig you can glue down, okay? So they be lying. But with Outre's Perfect Hairline, so far so good. I haven't really ran into, maybe all but one has been a little short when it comes to the ear-to-ear action. So Miss Cheyenne is definitely big head friendly. Pro number two, this curl is very, very pretty, and you get a lot of hair, okay? Now, I don't know if y'all wanna have all this hair on y'all head going into the summer, cause it's gonna get hot, okay? Real hot, and I don't know if you guys wanna like be out there sweating and, you know, like underneath all this hair, right? But you do get plenty of hair with this wig. Pro number three would definitely have to be this color. I tried, I think it was Charisma, made by Outre Perfect Hairline in the past. I totally did a video on that. Please go check it out. Help your girl out with the views. Thank you. Wink. But I tried this color once before. This is golden amber, and I absolutely like it. On the tutorial, you did see me kind of go in and tone this color down with my L'Oreal Root Touch-Up Spray in the color dark brown. And that's because when I first took Cheyenne off the pack, I was like, oh, she's screaming. She's yelling, and she's like, I am gold. Hear me roar, okay? That's what she was screaming at me, right? So I just totally had to just go in and spray her and kind of tone her down around the ends, and the roots already was this pretty kind of like four brown color. And if you guys hear like just like profuse tapping, that's my boo over there. He playing the game, and you already know he getting it in, okay? All right, so yeah, so I would definitely have to say, now that I have this, you know, the wig on and I see this color on my skin tone, I'm actually not mad at it. So that would have to be definitely a pro, is this color, which is a golden amber, okay? I don't want to end the pros without saying that this lace definitely melted. So I was not disappointed. with the way that the lace melted and laid down. So, yay. But that was kind of to be expected, dealing with Outre Perfect Hairline, okay? So, on to the cons. Definitely, my number one con would have to be her wearing this wig for a few hours now. I would definitely have to say my number one con is the knotting and tangling. I'm talking and, you know, and having a great time at my in-laws' house, and I am wearing my Shambhala beads that you guys see all the time in my videos, and I'm just talking, girl, you know, and I talk with my hands. I like to just gesture when I talk, right? And girl, I'm doing this, and it get caught in the weed, girl, right? So I had to kind of like low-key, you know, detangle the hair from my Shambhala beads while I was talking. Not good. So the tangling on this wig is definitely not good. And the fact that they filled it with filler hair and you have like this different pretty, you know, curl texture right here, but yet all underneath here and in the back is filler hair. And that is where you run into the frizzing, the tangling. Cheyenne definitely sheds, okay? This is a ball of hair that I got from Miss Cheyenne. Just from doing the pictures, taking pictures and everything for the thumbnail, I was running my fingers through Miss Cheyenne, and this is what I got. Tumbleweed, okay? So if y'all don't believe me, just watch. Okay, and I'm getting tangling already, y'all. And I only wore this hair for probably about 5 or 6 hours now. I haven't been having the Cheyenne on long at all. And I have already ran into tangling, knotting, and shedding. Which is very unfortunate because you are definitely going to run into that with a curly wig. And you're definitely going to run into that when they, you know, give you just a large amount of filler hair. But to run into that after only wearing Cheyenne for 6 to 7 hours is unacceptable, especially for the price I paid for her. I literally didn't spray anything in this wig. I didn't spray any water, I didn't spray any detangler, any mousse, or anything like that. What you see me do on the tutorial is all that I did to her. And yes, I must admit that the L'Oreal Root Touch Up, when you do spray it in your hair, it kind of like gives your hair a dry kind of feel to it. And it also kind of, you know, leaches off on your hands and stuff. But other than that, I still didn't put any alcohol, any products with alcohol in it. So I just don't understand where the knotting, see, I can't even run my fingers through it. And girl, I ain't trying to have my wig get ripped off on camera because that ain't cute. That's not cute at all, right? So, but I'm not understanding where the knotting, the kinking, and the shedding is coming from already, right? And so I just want y'all to see, I'm gonna separate the filler hair from the pretty curly hair that they put on top. And I hate when wig companies do that because I'm not stupid. I'm not dumb. I know what y'all doing. I know what y'all doing. Y'all fucking up. That's what y'all doing, okay? So, moving on to the rating. What do I rate Miss Cheyenne? I definitely have to give Miss Cheyenne a 6. And I know that is pretty low of a rating for such a great hairline series, right? Perfect Hairline, I've been doing a lot of these reviews for Perfect Hairline kind of like back to back on this channel. And so far I have been ranting and raving all good, well mostly good, about Perfect Hairline. And that I like their, you know, the amount of hair that they give you, the fact that the lace is flawless, it lays very well. And I also been ranting and raving about, in a good way, and bragging about how just pretty, you know, the curl textures and colors are. And although all those statements are very, very true, I have to, you know, like keep it real and be honest with you ladies. If you guys are gonna spend $50+ for a wig, this ain't it. this van. Okay? And that's disappointing because who has $50+ to waste? Okay? Right? So, nobody. Especially not in this time and in this climate, this economic climate, right? So, yes, I ran into a little bit of disappointment with this wig. This wig also reminds me of the L.37HD, whatever. I would insert the picture of the wig made by Motown Trace that I did a while ago, way, way, way down in my video list. You definitely could find the review on that wig from Motown Trace that is made exactly like Cheyenne. And I would definitely have to say, I didn't even run into the initial shedding, tangling, and downright frizzing that I ran into. I didn't run into that with that wig, but I ran into that with this wig. So if they, you know, were copying that wig exactly, they definitely didn't copy the good qualities of that wig. Okay, I'm showing a little bit favor, and here's why. When I usually do these videos, I definitely wear the wig overnight. I wear it for 12 hours plus. I go places. I let it blow in the wind. I run my fingers through it. I put products in it. And I am able to see how the endurance and upkeep of the wig is. And that is all the factors that I factor in to my rating, my final rating of a wig, right? So, because I haven't quite hit the overnight / 12 hour mark with this Cheyenne, I definitely don't want to give her a 5 or below because I feel like that is pretty, because I feel like that's kind of unfair, me not having worn it for like 12 hours or more. But being an experienced, you know, synthetic hair wearer, if that's a title, you kind of just know like where, what route, and you know, things are gonna go in. Like, you just know when you get a certain wig, that's a certain texture, that's a certain look and feel, right? You just know, you just could just foresee, you know. I just wish I could foresee the lottery numbers, right? But it's all good, it's okay, it's okay. But I rate her a 6. So with that, ladies, thank you so much for watching my tutorial and review for Miss Cheyenne made by Outre Perfect Hairline. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to your girl, JuicyNashae, okay? And if you haven't followed me on Instagram yet, I'm also on Instagram by the same name, JuicyNashae. Bye, y'all.